WandaVision is all about Westview TV. In this video, I'm going to take a look at the signals coming out of Westview and what exactly is the cosmic microwave background radiation. Hi there, I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and on this channel you'll find videos about the science and engineering behind superheroes and their superpowers. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and hit the bell so you get notifications on the latest videos. Let's get into it. In WandaVision, the town of Westview doesn't exist. Well, that's according to the locals who live nearby. However, Agent Jimmy Woo and Dr. Darcy Lewis think differently about Westview's existence. And it's Darcy, now a doctor of astrophysics, who discovers a signal coming out of Westview that's made up of two parts. The first part is a TV signal, and the second part is cosmic microwave background radiation. But what are TV signals, and what is the cosmic microwave background radiation? TV signals are actually waves, and these waves are part of the electromagnetic spectrum. Here is the electromagnetic spectrum. As you can see, the electromagnetic spectrum is home to a number of different radiation types. There's visible light in the center, to the right there are gamma rays and X-rays, and to the left is radio waves. And it's radio waves that I'm most interested in because TV waves, or TV signals, are contained within the range of radio waves. These waves all have different wavelengths, and Darcy refers to a long wavelength signal coming out of Westview. But what is wavelength? This is a wave. Now, this is a very simple wave. It's a sine wave. I've actually drawn it using the sine function in Excel. And I just want to point out a couple of features of such a wave. Those features are peaks and troughs. The peaks you'll find on the top of the wave, the troughs at the bottom. Now, the distance between successive peaks and successive troughs, that is the wavelength. And in physics, the symbol for wavelength is normally given as lambda. Now, this wavelength here could be representative of a radio wave because it looks like it's quite a long wavelength. And let's just compare it then to show you one with a shorter wavelength. And here you have a second wave, which has a much shorter wavelength than the first wave. As an astrophysicist, Dr. Darcy Lewis has seen plenty of radio waves in the past, and that's how she recognizes this signal coming from Westview. In space, there are objects that emit radio waves. One such object is a pulsar, and a pulsar is a high-density spinning neutron star. Galaxies have also been shown to emit radio waves. But there's one thing I have failed to address. Why am I talking about TV signals in terms of waves? In the modern world, TV signals are broadcast in the form of digital signals. That's in the form of ones and zeros. That's what digital TV is all about. Well, in the 20th century, TV signals were mainly broadcast as waves. In fact, they're better known as analog signals. And in WandaVision, the type of TV signals coming out of Westview really does honor the era of the TV show that's been broadcast from Westview. In the 1950s, because most TVs were black and white, TV signals only contained information that could be processed by a black and white TV. But in the 1960s and 1970s, when color TV started to become more popular, that's when TV signals were upgraded to include information about color. So as Wanda moves through the decades of the different types of shows in WandaVision, I think it wouldn't be surprising to see her shift to a digital broadcast when she reaches sitcoms set in the early 21st century. When Darcy realizes that the signal coming out from Westview is a TV signal, she asks for a really old TV. Not a flat screen TV, but a really old TV, and one that would be a cathode ray tube based TV. This is a type of television set that can interpret and convert those analog TV signals into a picture. And it uses inside the case of the TV an electron gun effectively to fire electrons at a phosphorus screen. You might be wondering, what exactly is the difference between a black and white TV signal and a color TV signal? A black and white TV signal contains a luminance signal. This is a signal that contains information about the brightness that should be on the screen. In the case of a color TV signal, not only will you have the luminance signal, but you'll also have an additional signal attached to that, which is the chrominance signal. And the chrominance signal, which is broadcast at a slightly different wavelength, will contain the information in relation to the colors that should be in the picture. The first hint of a color broadcast coming from Westview and Westview TV is shown in episode 2 of WandaVision. In that episode, Wanda picks up a sword drone that is in a bush outside of her house. When she picks it up, she sees it has been in color. And this information is broadcast in the TV signal to the outside world. So when that signal reaches the outside world and it's interpreted by the TV and aerial setup that Sword and Darcy Lewis have put in place, they can see the color in the broadcast. What about the CMBR signal that's coming from Westview? Well, CMBR stands for Cosmic Microwave Background Radiation. And in our universe, we have CMBR, well, everywhere. When the universe was formed at the Big Bang, it created all of space and all of time. And by the way, when I talk about the Big Bang here, I'm not referring to the TV series. The Big Bang created all of space and all of time, and all of the energy and, as a result, matter that we have in the universe. The Big Bang happened billions of years ago, and there is like a residue, a relic, a leftover that can be detected and seen in the sky above us and in the entire universe. And that relic, that leftover piece of information that indicates the Big Bang, it's actually been broadcast, using a word from WandaVision, in the microwave spectrum of wavelengths. Now, microwaves can be seen as a form of radio waves, and it's really up to you whether you see it as a radio wave or not. And when I talk about microwaves, I am not necessarily referring to microwave ovens, although the wavelengths that we use in microwave ovens would be in the range of microwaves as you would have on the electromagnetic spectrum. You may be wondering, can you detect the cosmic microwave background radiation? Well, you actually can, and what you need is one of those old TVs that I showed you earlier, a cathode ray tube TV. If you've got one of those TVs, and when you turn it on and it's not tuned to a channel, well, you'll see something that looks like this, and approximately 1% roughly of this signal you see here, this noise, this static effectively, is coming from the cosmic microwave background radiation. Yes, indeed, an old TV like a cathode ray tube TV can be used to detect or measure some part of that radiation. And finally, where is the extra CMBR coming from at Westview? We know that our universe has its own cosmic microwave background radiation, which is a relic of the Big Bang. But in WandaVision, there is some concern that there is an extra amount of this radiation being generated. So where is it coming from? Well, one place it could be coming from is the local universe created by Wanda Maximoff around Westview. This could be giving off additional cosmic microwave background radiation. Another potential source could be this. Perhaps in creating her brand new universe, Wanda has created ruptures in the multiverse and gateways to other versions of our universe. As a result, some of the cosmic microwave background radiation from those universes is spilling into ours. We'll just have to wait and see if that is the case. Thanks for watching this video in relation to TV signals and the cosmic microwave background radiation as featured in WandaVision. Please stay tuned for more videos in relation to superheroes, superpowers, science, engineering, and other topics. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and until I see you next time, always think super.